there, you won't be seeing that much of me in this video because this is another mythology and folklore video. Today we're taking a look at the Hulder, or Huldra as she's called here in Norway. In Sweden they call her Skogsrå. Yeah, that's what we're looking at today. I'll be showing you some artwork and some pictures, and I will be talking about this lady of the forest. If you like these kinds of videos, make sure to hit that big red button and subscribe, because I have a lot more of these things coming up. Today we're taking a look at the Hulder, or Skogsrå as they call her in Sweden, a seductive lady of the forest that could be both helpful and dangerous. Scandinavians describe her slightly differently, but I have no doubt it's the same lady. There are several different rådare, or rå, as we call them, keepers or wards. They rule over the area they're in and watch over it. In this video, I'm only dealing with the forest variety. Examples of others are those for sea, mountains, mines, and ships. In Norway, the Hulder has often been described as a typical dairymaid with the clothes of a regular farm girl, although somewhat more beautiful and tempting than most girls. She has long fair hair and her back is often hollow, like an old log. In Sweden, she's described as exceptionally beautiful, but she can also blend into nature and take the shape of a tree, a mossy rock, or a tree stump. She usually appears as an attractive woman, though, either with strangely expensive clothes for someone in the forest, or naked. In addition to the hollow back, she sometimes has a tail, often a cow tail or fox tail, which is barely visible below the hem of a dress. Further north in Sweden, her back isn't hollow, but she usually has that tail. The name Vitra is more common in northern Sweden than Skogsrå, but we'll get to the Vitra folk later in this series. Many only think of the women, but they are a people, so there are men as well. Whereas the female Hulder is almost invariably described as incredible, seductive, and beautiful, the males of the same race are often said to be hideous. The forest animals are under the protection of the Hulder, and she has the power to decide whether a hunter should have good luck or not. The Siberian jay is her messenger and keeps her informed about everything that happens. Anyone who sees a Siberian jay when they go out hunting can just turn back home, because the Hulder will ensure that the animals stay away. Despite the fact that only a few of the Hulder stories are about sexuality, the theme is still an important part of this creature's character. The Hulder likes to seek out men who are in her area. Above all, she seems to like coal burners, lumberjacks, and hunters. However, you can never really know if her flirtation has good or evil intentions. If she manages to seduce a man, she gets power over him. He then becomes silent, difficult to deal with, and is tormented by a constant desire for her. In Sweden, there have previously been laws against interaction with the Hulder. In a preserved document from 1685, a man named Mats is accused of having had relations with a Hulder. According to the case report, this Hulder was very beautiful, dressed in a white robe, red socks, and a fur coat. If a man started a relationship with the Hulder and then tried to get away from her, he could live dangerously. She could use her magic powers to ruin him. If he was a hunter, he'd better change profession. But she could also drive him mad or make him seriously ill. At worst, he died in a more or less mysterious way. But there are also stories about happy marriages and children coming from relations with the Hulder. In addition to many erotic stories, there are also stories about men who heard her sing in the forest, and servant girls alone on a mountain farm who saw her with her cattle and thought her to be one of them. Most of the Hulder's contact with humans is almost harmonious, but it can get problematic at times.
She might help the hunter so he gets a good hunt, but she can also make sure no animals go near him, especially her own animals. It's been said that she helped coal burners keep their kiln or mound burning and waked them if it burned too hot, either by screaming or throwing the door open. The Hulda could also help bring back animals that had run off and keep lost children dry and warm until they were found. She sometimes tempts people astray, gets them lost, and then disappears with a wicked laugh. In addition to blaming elves and trolls, people also blame the Hulder for more permanent disappearances. The Hulder also stole cattle on occasion. If she was mistreated, she could take revenge on the person who did her wrong or disrespected her. A hunter who insulted her would lose his hunting luck for the foreseeable future. A coal burner who did the same could look forward to an accident in the mound. People who faced her could often get scared. On the other hand, a girl in Värmland said that the Hulder had laughed so friendly that she regretted not talking to her.
Thanks for watching. I hope you liked that summary of the Hulder and that you'll come back next time. Next week is a different kind of video, but I will come back with another folklore video in not so very long. So if you liked it, remember to hit the thumbs up, share it with your friends, and come back and see me next week. Bye-bye.